Hey, Journeys Crossing. As we closed our series last Sunday, What Would Jesus Undo? We talked about pride and specifically spiritual pride. And as we invite the Holy Spirit to have a look very deep in our hearts, we can help him by identifying the sure symptoms of spiritual pride. And those were self-sufficiency, comparison, fault-finding, attention-seeking, and false humility. All of us can find at least one of those symptoms somewhere in our hearts or in our thoughts, maybe in our conversations or our actions. And in case none of these symptoms seem to be true to you, let's look a little deeper into a few of them today. Self-sufficiency, that can be directly measured by the amount of time we spend in one activity, prayer. When we pray, we acknowledge that we need God to live in and through us every moment of every day as we maintain a constant connection with him. As Mark put it, prayer is a desperate attempt on our part to say, we need you. If instead of praying, these thoughts rattle around in your head like, I got this, or I'm good on my own, or I don't need any help, then you need Jesus to undo your self-sufficiency. This lone ranger mentality can extend to our relationships with others too, like avoiding a small group or avoiding accountability relationships or intimate friendships. That shows that we think we don't need others, but God says otherwise, telling us to never neglect getting together with believers. Maybe you're doing well with depending on God, so let's look at another one. Let's look at comparison. Comparison can creep into our hearts. Many of us struggle with comparing ourselves to others constantly, and it's often rooted in our own insecurity. Christ wants us to be completely secure in how he sees us, to free us from this exhausting, futile practice, which leaves us either puffing ourselves up or feeling like zeros. Another symptom was fault-finding. And it's related to that excessive comparison. As we battle insecurity or simply don't feel great about ourselves or our work, we suddenly develop this 20/20 vision in finding the real and perceived faults of others, remaining blind to our own pride and neediness. Things like, why does she dress that way? Or, there's something about him that bugs me. Why do they always come to small group late? He talks too much about his kids. And on it goes. Fault finding is spiritual pride. So let's zip it when analyzing others and instead beat our own chests like the tax collector, imploring God for his mercy. So which of those three symptoms will lead you to call on God today? Let's pray together. Lord, I often see myself as self-sufficient, and I know you will work to show me that I'm not. Help me to turn to you first and avoid more painful lessons. Help me also to stop comparing myself to others and finding fault with them. I don't want my words to be like poison or my mind to be rotted. Cleanse me today of spiritual pride. Amen. I can't wait to see you guys Sunday at our new series, and I'm looking forward to Easter, where we can be both online and in person. Have a great day. Bye.